about that. All right, our pet crisis has been handled. So this is the merino roving. And if you grab a hold of that merino roving and you try to pull it, it is really, really strong and I could not pull this apart. The tensile strength of hair is very, very strong, deceptively strong. So what you need to do is move your hands apart more and those fibers will just slide right out from one another. This is a very thick piece of roving, so I'm going to take that and I'm going to split that into two. And now we are going to begin laying out this project. And a lot of felters are really crazy about how they pull the roving, how they do their layout, how thin and how fine it is. And when you're doing Nuno, which is wet felting on top of silk, it's more important that you have it thin and fine. But for this wet felting project, for a beginner's project, this is great because you don't really have to be so exact on how thin and fine you pull it out. It's okay. This is not a big deal. All right, so I'm going to start. I take my hand on the edge of the roving and move my hands further apart. Just give a gentle tug on it so that the fibers slide apart from one another, and I begin laying them out on my little template here. So there we go. Just laying them right across the edge, and what I'm doing is I'm shingling them on top of one another. So the last part is slightly overlapping the last piece that you've laid. Your next one shingles on top of it. And I am going to do this all the way down the project. There we go. Down to the end there. This guy has a little hole. I'm going to close that hole up. And I'm going to continue. Now, sometimes your fibers in your wool can be thin, put together, meaning it's not that wide. So you might have to take them and pull them out because it's actually quite a bit of fiber. So you have to take them and fluff them out a little bit. So I finished my first layer and I've laid it directly to the edge of the bubble wrap. And now I'm going to begin laying my second layer. And my second layer, I'm going to do that in the opposite direction. So this was laid horizontally. I'm now going to do a layer perpendicular. And I'm going to do the same thing, shingling the fibers on top of one another. Okay, so my base layer is complete, so I'm just gonna go over it and just tap it down, take a look at it, make sure that there's no spots where I can see my bubble wrap peeking through, so I know that there's not gonna be any holes in my project. And this looks fantastic. So we are ready to go on to our design layer. So let's see here. I'm gonna reach around over here and grab the I'm going to grab this lovely blue color, Atlantic, which I love this. It's a very tealy color. And for your design layer, you don't need a whole lot of roving. That will go into another project. So I'm going to start laying out my design layer here. And have some nice blue color up the top. And just so that you know, when you're doing the edge of a project, if you lay out your fibers horizontally first, you'll have more of a straight line. If you lay out your fibers perpendicular, you get more of a wavier edge. So I don't care about these little guys sticking out. Like, I think that they give it character. I don't mind them at all. So there we go, I am done with that color. And now I am going to lay down, this is my silk mesh. And I'm just gonna lay that right on there. And then I'm gonna add in my silk hankies. And just a word of caution on the silk hankies. Since it's so fine, it catches on everything. So it will catch on your cuticles and it will catch on your nails. So it might be a good idea to just go over them with a nail file before you start this project and aggravate yourself. So I'm gonna take these two guys and set them out. Like so. And then I'm gonna go over it with some of my bamboo silk. Just get a piece of bamboo silk here and I'll be right back. Okay. So now the bamboo silk can have a really cool effect. I'm gonna grab my other piece here and show you. The bamboo silk can get this spiderwebby effect on here. It has a very nice organic look to it. Or you can put it more together and have it look more like leaves. So if you fluff it out, you'll get an effect like this. And if you have it more together, you'll get more like waves.